Hi, my name is Ian Gack with Explosive Swing, and today I want to go over the water bottle drill with you. This is a great drill to help teach you to use your backside the right way. Have good direction with the backside through the hitting zone, transferring energy from the back to the front, against the front side, or through the front side and through the zone, transferring that energy into the baseball or into the softball and delivering it to where you want it to go, to the middle of the field. All right? This is particularly good for anybody that squishes the bug. All right? Got the sit and spin hitters, right? Just turning that back foot just like that, heels going back. And when this happens, nothing's being transferred forward and all our energy, our bat path, everything is just kind of working across the zone. All right, so from the front side, if I'm just squishing the bug, everything's just kind of spinning, going across. If I'm gonna take the inside part of my back knee, drive it hard in and forward like I should, getting up to that big toe, right? My energy now going through the zone, back into the baseball or softball, the way I want it to, okay? Are you gonna hit a ball hard squishing the bug sometimes? Yeah, sure, but it's not gonna be consistent the way you want to. You're not gonna be through the zone as long as you want to either, all right? So how you perform the drill, take a water bottle or any object you want. You can take a bucket for if you want to, if it's available to you, but water bottles are nice. They're pretty small, easy access to them. Make sure you have about half the bottle filled up so there's some weight so it doesn't just get blown over in the wind. And you're gonna put that down next to your back foot, give yourself about an inch of clearance, maybe half inch, but you don't want your foot all the way up against it, and you don't wanna go too far to where it doesn't matter, right? So have about an inch, within an inch away from it. And first thing I'd recommend, no bat, just work on driving the inside part of our back knee in and forward towards my front heel, okay? And if I'm using my backside the right way, I should have plenty of clearance from the bottle, probably 8-9 inches away, okay? Just work on that without the bat in our hands. Inside knee move, okay? Taking the inside part of our knee, driving it forward. If I spin, squish the bug, we're gonna knock it over every time, okay? Or whatever object you're using, you're gonna be hitting it, okay? So, but after you feel comfortable without the bat, get the bat in your hands, set the ball on the tee, and this could be done with side toss, front toss, BP as well. I'm just gonna demonstrate off the tee. But set the tee up, get in your stance, your setup, line up the home plate the right way, put the bottle down next to your back foot, get ready to swing, okay? Drive my backside the right way. I'm gaining plenty of distance away from it, about a foot away. If I'm gonna sit here, squish the bug now, look like this. I'm gonna sit and spin, I'm gonna knock that water bottle over every time, okay? So, highly recommend getting comfortable with it before you swing. Put that bottle next to your back foot and take your swings. Again, great to do off side toss, front toss, BP as well, okay? Couple things to be aware of. All right, we want to work on turning the inside part of our back knee hard in and forward, but we want to make sure we're keeping our head roughly between our feet, so we're working against that front side. One thing that younger kids in particular will do, if you don't have good control over your body, will start to push off and drift away from the bottle, which is going to create its own problems as well. Okay, so we're going to be careful that we're not doing this. We're working hard against that front side, getting up to that big toe, transferring that energy forward through the zone, okay? Definitely do this with pitch in, pitch away, pitch middle. It works for all pitches. All right, it's the water bottle drill. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to check out ExplosiveSwing.com.